In this video, we will analyze step response behavior of an op-amp RL circuit, which technique integrates an op-amp with an inductor and, of course, resistor. Okay, so it's given that VIT input voltage is equal to time times U of t, which means that, so before t is equal to 0 or t less than 0, VI is equal to 0 volts, and when t is greater than or equal to 0, VI is equal to 10 volts. So we can connect voltage source like this. This is 10. Okay, so in general, we assume that right before t is equal to 0, the circuit is in under steady state condition. Since input voltage is 0, there is no source in the system, so inductor current IL0 is equal to, okay, so IL0 is equal to 0 initial condition. So in this case, what we can do is we can write IL of t like this, I infinity times 1 minus e to the power minus t divided by tau. Okay, so the output is the voltage of the op-amp, okay, which is V naught of t. But since we have an inductor, we will first find IL of t, then we will try to figure out what is the output voltage. Okay, good. So what we need to do is we need to compute the time constant and a steady state current of the inductor. Okay, let's start with the time constant. Okay, so as I told you in the previous video, there are two ways of doing this. One way of doing this, computing equivalent resistance between the inductor current, okay? And by doing that, what we need to do is we need to connect a voltage source or current source. It's a known value, compute the current in this direction. Of course, in order to do that, we need to kill the all of the like active sources, which is the VI, and then come up with an R equivalent, then we can compute the time constant of the RL circuit. Okay, but instead, what I will do is I will find an ODE with respect to the inductor current, and then it's fairly easy to compute the time constant. Okay, good. So this is, let's say, I1, okay, the current. This is I5, and let's call it, this is IL, okay. So this is the inductor voltage, and it is easy to see that VL is equal to V5 voltage of the resistor, and it is equal to V naught. Okay, so it simplifies some of the things. Okay, now we can write KVL. I1 plus I5 plus IL is equal to 0. Okay, so what is I1? I1 is equal to 10 divided by 100. What is I5? VL divided by 500. That's good. So what is IL? IL is just IL. IL is equal to 0, that's good. So let's move on to a clean place. So 1 over 500 VL, instead of VL, we write L times di over dt. So what is L? 0.5, okay, dIL over dt plus IL is equal to minus 0.1. Okay, that's good. So we have a value here, okay, and actually this is the time constant, because in general what we do is we write y, or let's say, okay, so let's write this, okay, so when we write di over dt plus lambda il is equal to some constant, 1 over lambda is equal to the time constant, so it's technically equal to this value. So time constant is equal to 0.5 divided by 500, which is equal to 10 to the power minus 3 seconds. Okay, let's check if it's correct. It should be equal to correct. Yes, it is correct. So we computed the time constant. Okay, so what is next? Computing the steady state current of the inductor. So we can compute that directly from here. Okay, sorry. Let's do that. Okay, so what is that? It is technically the particular solution. Okay. Because what we assume that current is constant because input is constant, and we plug into the equation and it's the particular solution. Okay, so let's assume that IL is constant, derivative is zero. Technically, IL infinity is equal to minus 0.1, so I infinity is equal to minus 0.1 amps. Okay, that's good. So this is one way of computing that direct from the differential equation, which is perfectly easy, as you can see. We can also compute IL using the steady state condition assumptions. In that case, this will be short circuit. it will be technically eliminate the resistance, and IL is equal to minus VI, okay, minus 10 divided by 100, which is equal to 0.1L. Okay, so I computed IL, I infinity, I computed tau. So in that sense, IL of t is equal to minus 0.1 times 1 minus e to the power minus 1000 t. Okay, so let's check. Okay, it's correct. This is correct. This is correct. Let's look at the expression. As you can see, everything's correct. So I computed IL, inductor current, but in the problem, I need to compute V naught, output voltage. So I know that V naught is equal to VL, okay, and it is equal to L times DI over DT. So what should I do is I should take the derivative of this expression with respect to T and multiply with L. So V naught of T is equal to 0.5 times 0.51 times 0.5, that's good. Derivative of this is equal to minus 1000, that's good. Okay, e to the power minus 1000 t. Okay, so V0t should be equal to, I guess, minus 50 e to the power minus 1000 t volts. Okay, that's good. So this is the output expression. Okay, and it is significantly different from the RC circuit that we saw in the previous video. Okay, because this starts from a constant, which is minus 50, and it goes to zero. Okay, so in the previous case, the voltage starts from zero, and it goes to minus infinity, minus 50, so for that. So one is like going to zero, one is going to a steady state voltage, which is given by the circuit's topology. The previous circuit was a technically first order low pass filter. I will talk about later when we cover these phasors. And this is a first order high pass filter, which technically eliminates DC voltage as time goes to infinity.